Another sign the Bay Area is recovering from the pandemic, the San Francisco Ballet returning to the stage next month at the Frost Amphitheater, presenting its Starry Nights. Joining me now is Artistic Director Helgi Tomasson. Helgi, thanks for joining us.
Well, nice to be here.
Can you tell us a little bit about the show itself?
Yes, we are presenting a program of sort of neoclassics and new works. One is a Balanchine work that is a classic. It's being seen and performed all over the world by all the ballet companies in the world. It's called Serenade. Then we go into three shorter pieces, one by Daniel Rowe, and another one with Balanchine, and one by myself. And then we finish with the fifth season, which is more contemporary.
So getting back in action must have been a challenge. How were you even able to rehearse safely with all the COVID protocols in place?
Well, we were very lucky. About a year ago, exactly in August, we were allowed to go six dancers at the time in a pod, standing 12 feet apart, to just get started and get in shape. Then by September, we were allowed to be more in a rehearsal mode and create things. And we managed to create four ballets during the pandemic. And right now we have another choreographer creating a new work for us. And we are now all together in a studio, very, very happy dancers, creating things and being almost like normal. Of course, we are being tested every week. And we are very conscious of the protocol that the Health Department of San Francisco requires us to do. So we want the health and the safety of the dancers, of course, first. But the idea of being able to perform live again for an audience in this beautiful amphitheater at Stanford is just thrilling for us. And they're so excited about it. It's been a long haul, you know, since the early March of last year.
Yeah, talk a little bit about that sort of, you know, people whose life it is to dance and be in front of an audience to suddenly be grounded like that.
It wasn't easy by any means because dancers need to practice every day. They need to have a big studio space to move around and practice their art form. And they were not able to do that being sheltering at home. So most of them were just trying to stay in shape in their living room, in their kitchens, doing the ballet exercises the best they could. And for several months at the time, that was really hard for all of them. And,
yeah, I'm sure. Yeah, trying to do it, especially with the small real estate we have, you know, around the Bay Area to do some of these things, I can't even imagine.
Yeah, that was really hard for them. But I'm very proud of them. Dancers tend to be very disciplined normally, and they stuck to the protocol and they did the best they could under the very difficult circumstances. And now, as you can imagine, they're thrilled to be back in the studio, practicing freely and as normal as can be.
And tell us how to get tickets if we're interested in seeing the show.
Available through Stanford Live website. It's called live.stanford.education. And there are two performances on the 13th and 14th of August. And I think it's going to be a beautiful setting and incredible night for everybody who's going to be there.
Wonderful. All right. We look forward to it. Helgi Tomasson from the San Francisco Ballet. Thanks.
Well, thanks. Nice to talk to you. Thank you.